I threw it away, yet it drops like grains of golden sand from my fingers onto my feet. As I read those strange old faces every day, oh, I try to stay awake. Well, I hope until the day I wake.
Greetings, citizens, real-life superheroes, and my brethren of the supervillain community. Now, there's a couple of issues I thought I should address.
Theater in Shakespeare's day was sophisticated, plentiful, and hugely popular. The Globe was Shakespeare's theater, and like many other public theaters, it was located on the south bank of the River Thames, almost entirely open air, clearly open to the elements, so no way to protect from the weather. The audience sat around the outside edge of the ring in three levels. The higher up one sat, the more expensive the seat. It became popular among young noblemen to sit here, so they could not only see the play, but be seen themselves.
What are the qualifications that make you supervillains? One has to kill thousands? The greatest supervillain of our time built the American people billions of dollars. His name was Madoff. Anyone could have seen that coming. You made off with your money. Now you can kill a man. Charles Manson? Killed no one? No! Never a knife touched his hand. He was a supervillain. Citizens, superheroes, ponder upon that and think to yourself, do supervillains really exist? Yes, they do. As sure as my name is.
A quick note about costumes. It wasn't a custom at this time for actors to dress in anything other than contemporary clothing, which brings us to the important topic of women in Elizabethan theater. There weren't any.
Cold pain, I cannot sustain it. That's what I'm thinking, not what I'm drinking. Hold up my ways. Thoughts are pervasive. It's not a statement, but peace can be evasive. You're a mouthful, that a mouthful. Another week on my own. Now I'm a novel, made resourceful. I start a chain with my thought. Talk is cheap, my darling. When you're feeling right at home,
que nos quiten en la vida, oye, hay que sufrir.
The stage itself was raised and partially covered by a kind of canopy known as the heavens. The canopy was supported by wooden pillars painted to look like marble. We've barely scratched the surface of the fascinating history of Elizabethan theater. I encourage you to research and explore the public theaters, the private theaters like Blackfriars, other renowned actors, Shakespeare's famous scenic designer Inigo Jones, the children's companies, and any other aspect of this fruitful time that intrigues you.